Good day, everyone. I am Dr. B, and this is Reflection in Minutes. If you are new to this channel, please like and share this video to spread the love of God. You may also want to subscribe by pressing the bell button below to receive future updates. I am currently in our house in Batangas, so please forgive me if you see or if you hear crickets or running vehicles because our house is located along a national highway. Anyway, in today's pilot episode, we'll talk about new creations. The verse is lifted from 2 Corinthians 5:17 and it reads, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old is gone and the new is here." This is one of the verses that inspired me in my first few days as Christian. This verse reminds us that as a newly born Christian, we are indeed a new creation through the love and grace of Jesus. And He paid it with an expensive price. That is, through His blood when He died from the cross. No one can outdo what He did there, not even our good works. It is by His grace alone. Jesus died to give you life. So, as a new creation of God, what are we supposed to do? Number one is to forsake our previous sins. Remember, the old is gone and the new is here. You have to surrender your old and bad habits to Him. Meaning, if in your previous life you have been gambling, you have been involved in immoral sex, you have been drinking alcohol, have been smoking, or have been addicted to porn, it is about time to stop it. It is not easy, but nothing is impossible with God. Pray for the guidance of the Holy Spirit to convict you whenever you are being enticed to commit those sins again. Secondly, you have to be alert. The enemy is everywhere and they know your weakest point. The scripture reminds us in 1 Peter 5:8 to be alert and sober mind. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. The enemy knows where to hit us, so make sure that you pay attention to any potential turn of events that the enemy may lure you to commit those sins again. And lastly, always open your line of communications to God. Drown yourself in prayers and His words. The enemy pales in comparison with our ever-powerful God. It is only through Him that we can withstand all our trials and tribulations. Being a Christian is not easy. It entails temptations, and sometimes, or even many times, we could fall into those trials. But always remember the love of Jesus. We may fail as a new creation at times, but we can always get back in the battlefield. And because Jesus loves us, we can do all things through Him who strengthened us. I am Dr. B, and this is once again Reflection in Minutes. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. As the rain is now starting to pour, it means that God is blessing everyone.